Hello, guys, and welcome back. It has been a long time. Family time and quality time with Microsoft support. Figuring out why my Forzas didn't work for a week and a half. Hope you guys had a splendid Christmas, and hope you guys have an awesome 2018. Now, on to the rally, of course. It is 1992, and after years of World Touring Car Championship and Group A Racing and IMSA Racing, Alfa Romeo wanted to branch out their Alfa Corse division to accommodate rally, and more specifically, Group B rally. Unfortunately, the idea of a rally car being made out of the Turbo Evolution 75 model was not accepted by the big bosses, so Alfa took one of the Bathurst World Touring Car Championship cars with the 3-liter V6 and spruced it up a little bit. The car was already very light, at 1,095 kilograms, so they kept it naturally aspirated to keep the weight as an advantage. They tuned the double overhead cam V6 to 252 kilowatts or 337 horsepower and 399 newton meters of torque. The car was also installed with 245 tires all round, not the max that they can run in the class, but close. This is Alfa's first go on the dirt. Can the car prove itself to be competitive enough? We shall go and see. Hey, it's now the time of the Alfa Romeo 75 or Milano, depends on where you live in the world. Well, let me first talk a little bit about why I was so absent this week and a half. It was because, for some or other reason, my Microsoft account got corrupted and I couldn't access the games. It was a week and a half constantly talking to the guys at Microsoft, the tech support, and trying to figure out what the hell was wrong with my game. We went through everything, uninstalling the game, installing the game with and without antivirus, you name it, I did it. From the morning at 8 till the evening at 6, I was constantly busy. So, yeah, but luckily we figured out where it was. It's just the account that was corrupted. We resetted the account and we are here. Luckily I didn't lose any of my saved game data, so I'm happy. Yeah, and it gave me a little bit of time to be with my family and so. Family time is always good time, as I would say. But let's talk a little bit about this Alfa Romeo 75 or Milano. First up, the brakes. Pretty good. Okay, but we're not going that fast. This isn't the fastest car we've been driving it. Speed-wise, it compares to the Opel Manta, and as you remember, it wasn't the fastest car around here. But this is almost like its main rival. Front engine, rear wheel drive, naturally aspirated, just weighs just over a ton. If Alfa Romeo would have competed, it would have been with this car. In the 90s. But if it was the 80s, I would believe they would have competed with the old GTV, but unfortunately it's not in the game. In South Africa we had a nice GTV. It was only made for South Africa, as I've came to know it, the 3.2 GTV. Europe only had the 3-liter V6, and yeah, it was specially made in South Africa. I think it was Juan Giovanni or Galgoli or some sort of Italian named guy. He moved from Italy to South Africa. He's still today well known for modifying Ferraris and Alfa Romeos. He made the World Touring Car Alfa Romeo GTV that competed. He made the engine, and that V6 I think could have revved to 9,000 or 10,000 RPMs. 2:38.65. Yeah, he's a brilliant man, and he knows his Alphas, and he knows how to tune his Alphas, and to make it reliable, because that is one of the major drawbacks of Alfa Romeo. Yeah, so, brakes, performance, yeah, the engine is smooth, as you would expect from an Alfa Romeo V6, but it lacked a little bit of oomph up top, especially if you're going above 170 kilometers per hour, so you need to keep a smooth line, you need to use the brakes as little as possible. But you don't want to slide around a lot with this car. You need to be very, very gentle with it to keep it as fast as possible, because you don't have the plus point like all the other cars of fast acceleration, so you need to keep the momentum going through the corner. What can I tell you more about? This car really was a little bit sluggish. I think it is also, I don't know how good the aerodynamics are done on this game. The Alfa Romeo is quite square. I don't know the drag coefficient of the Alfa Romeo. Maybe it's quite good. I don't know. And to the point that I always want to bring up is, why didn't Alfa Romeo compete in the rally? They had some brilliant cars. The 155 Q4. Yet again, it was in the wrong year at the wrong time. It was also 3-liter V6. I don't even know if there's a class that still exists that caters for the big naturally aspirated engines. Sometimes I see in the Netherlands 350Zs and BMWs competing in a rally, but I don't know in what class they are running. I don't know if it's almost like a specially made class for them to run in, almost like straight six V6 rear wheel drive cars. But Alfa Romeo was always very good in circuit racing, and most of the time circuit racing names also had a rally division, like Audi with the Audi 80 and 100 that competed in IMSA, or the Global Touring Car Championship. World Touring Car Championship, and then the Audi Quattro, and then there was the Hill Climb Quattros. They branch out quite a lot, but Alfa Romeo always sticked to the circuit racing and never to something else. I don't even know if they ever made a hill climb car, for that matter. It's only circuit racing cars that I know of. 2:40.213. As you can see there, some of the corners I messed up a little bit, so my time wasn't that good. Alfa Romeo lacked a lot. I wasn't hoping or expecting much from the Alfa Romeo. They, for its first try on my Group B, but I expected 10 years of technology advancement. It would have been a little bit faster and a little bit more power out of the engine naturally aspirated. What did it make again? 252 kilowatts. I expected in the 90s that a naturally aspirated car would easily made 100 kilowatt per liter, or was it 160 horsepower per liter, that sort of number, like a Honda S2000. Especially racing engines from Alfa Romeo, I think from the 70s, had almost like 100 kilowatt per liter. That was almost like a benchmark to aim at for racing cars till today. Formula 1 cars, yes, they make, it's a 1.6 that makes 400 or 500 kilowatts. It's insane. But that's with the help of a turbocharger with naturally aspirated. I think that old V10s, what did they made? It was 700, 800 horsepower. And the V10s were, I can't remember the size. Was it 3-liter V8 and 5-liter V12? It must be smaller. I think it was like a 4-liter V12, but it made just made over 100 kilowatt per liter at the 500 kilowatt mark. It was expected of that, but this car couldn't reach it for some other reason. And the reason I chose to keep it at the minimum weight is because I can't go wider than 245 tires. It doesn't help me to take it into the next class, turbocharge it, or keep it naturally aspirated, and you can't put the power down because the tires are too small. So that is one of my main factors of how I do the cars according to the rules. I have a plan for a new series. I'm gonna test it out and see how it is, and then hopefully I'll get it out in this next week or so. But okay, cross the line, the last run, let's see. 2:39.229. Not as fast as the first lap, and it ended up in 30th position. Not that good, but it beat the Opel Manta and the Volvo 242 Turbo. Not that bad. If you think about it, the Volvo had quite a lot of power, but it was a little bit on the heavy side. Italian competition, Lamborghini Jalpa, 2:34.796. Faster, the Lancia 037, 4.6 seconds faster than the Alfa Romeo. That's quite a lot. But also, it is supercharged. You can't actually compete them against one another. The Opel Manta is its main competitor, and he beat it by a mile. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Please leave a like. Please comment down below. Vote for the next car at the top right corner. And until next time, guys, keep it sideways, keep it fun. Drift Buddy, out. Thank you.